Hi, in this video, we'll learn how to use the paint tool in Procreate 4. Hi, I'm ebadams, children's author who publishes his stories on YouTube. I'm also passionate about teaching my kids to be content creators. If you missed my intro video about teaching kids to draw using Procreate, be sure to click up here for that, especially if you're a parent. Okay, so let's jump in. I'm opening up the Procreate app. It opens up in what is called the gallery. You can see all the images I've created. Here you can see my work and my kids' work. Somehow my kids are using this more than I am. That's cool. On the top right corner is the plus symbol. Tap on it and it'll give you a popover with a list of different canvas size options. Select by tapping the first one that says screen size. Now let's start with your fancy Apple pencil. Start making marks on the canvas. The canvas is this white area you see. Play around the way you would with a paper and pencil. Try light strokes, try hard strokes. But you don't need to go super hard. Try going light too hard. Now try going fast or slow. You can even tilt your pencil the way you might shade with the lead of a real pencil, and it will add texture, or sometimes called grain. Texture is what a surface looks like. Skin, fur, metal, clouds, water, they all have different textures. Congratulations, you now know how to use the paint tool. The paint tool is up here, and it's the first one from the left. You know you're using it because it turns blue when you have it selected. Next to it is the smudge and erase tools. There are also useful drawing tools, but we'll get to them in another video. What makes drawing digitally so fun is brushes. Check this out. Tap on the paintbrush icon. These are all the brushes that come with Procreate, but you can add your own or make your own. There's two columns. On the left is the brush sets, and on the right are all the brushes in that brush set. Now tap on a brush to select it. The brush you have selected will turn blue. If you tap on a brush twice, it'll take you to its settings. Don't worry about this for now. Just tap on the back arrow on the top left to go back. Now, select the brush and play around with it the same way you played around with it before. Go light and hard, go fast and slow, then try another brush. Notice the texture and grain that each brush has or doesn't have. You'll notice each brush not only looks different, but acts different. Some will get darker when you push down harder, while others stay the same. Some will get bigger when you push down harder, while others stay the same size. Some will mix in a wet paint-like way with what you've already put down, while others will just go over it like a highlighter or a marker. Playing around and observing what a brush does is a great way to learn, and it will make it easier to choose the right brush for what you want to do. Some brushes might be better for drawing lines, others might be more suited for shading and coloring in, and others might only be useful for adding that little bit of texture when you need it. Well, this one is too big. You can adjust the size of the brush by using the size slider over here. Just tap on the slider and drag it up or down. You can see the size of your brush change as you do so. Now that's better. The other slider below it is the opacity slider. That controls how much you can see through or the transparency of your strokes. Low opacity will give you a lot of transparency. Just try it and you'll know what I mean. Transparency is an important part of working digitally, especially later when we talk about layers. Sometimes I would accidentally drag this all the way down and I wouldn't be able to draw. And I would go crazy trying to figure out why I can't draw. It was because my opacity was at 0%. Okay, so we learned to change the size and opacity, but wow, this is a lot of black. I think it's time to add color, don't you? We'll get to that in the next video. So let's just do a quick review of what we learned. Each brush has different characteristics. Play around and observe what happens when you control the speed, pressure, even the tilt of your Apple Pencil. Also observe the shape and size, the opacity, and the texture and grain of each brush. By knowing what a brush is capable of doing, the easier it is to choose the right brush when you need it. Personally, I just use a couple of brushes. One for drawing line, another for coloring in, and a few for when I want to add a bit of texture on top. Each brush will have a different use for you, so I encourage you to play around and find the brushes you like and think about how you might use them. So that's it for using the paint tool in Procreate. In my next video, I'll go over changing colors and using the color popover. This is a series I wanted to make for my kids to give them a foundation in digital painting. I'm also hoping it's useful for anyone who's an absolute beginner. I also produce stories for kids on YouTube, and I like to think they're for the young and young at heart. So be sure to subscribe so you don't miss them. Thanks.